Our next kind of non-Mendelian genetics are polygenic traits. Poly means many, and these are phenotypes or traits that are due to the interaction of several genes. And really, what we mean is the different enzymes that those different genes produce are all interacting to create one single phenotype. Eye color and skin color are good examples of traits that are not due to the interaction of just a couple alleles. They're due to the interaction of several alleles across several genes. And here is what a Punnett square might look like for a trait that is determined by three different genes. And what I want to show you here is that each gene, A, B, A, B, has a dominant recessive relationship. But here all of the recessive alleles are occurring. Here all the dominant alleles are occurring. And then we have all of these other different combinations that give you a variety of skin colors. So one of the ways you can identify, again, looking out at a population, if a trait is polygenic, is if it's a quantitative trait. And what that means is a trait that has many, many possibilities, not just one or two or three options, but 10, 20, 30 possibilities. So if you look at the height of people in a community, there's not just two or three options, there's a range. And that tells you that height is determined, in addition to environmental effects, by a variety of traits interacting. Just for fun, there's a little activity you can do. It's called an eye color calculator, and you can find this by Googling the tech eye color, and I will show you what happens. You click on here and you just put some information in. So I have green eyes. Yes, I have blue-eyed siblings. My husband has brown eyes, and he does not have siblings with other colored eyes. His parents both have brown eyes. My dad had green eyes, and my mom has brown eyes. Calculate. And here we look at all the possibilities and likelihoods for different eye colors and genes that they might be carrying. And this is a very simple example, but you start to see the probabilities in the different genotypes and phenotype potential. Just for the record, both of my kids have brown eyes. Finally, the last piece of non-Mendelian genetics I want to talk about are sex-linked traits. And remember that we have 23 pairs of chromosomes. The first 22 are what we call autosomes. They are the same in men and women. The 23rd pair are the sex chromosomes. And there's two versions. There's an X chromosome and a Y chromosome. And the Y chromosome carries the genes specific to becoming male, the SRY gene. In mammals, if you have two X chromosomes, you are female. And if you have an X and a Y, you are male. Now, there are what we call Y-linked traits, and these are related to becoming male, and they're passed from father to son only. With X-linked traits, recessive traits are always expressed in men, and in women, they are more often carriers, and they will only express the trait if they're homozygous recessive. So colorblindness is a classic X-linked recessive trait. So this is a gene that's found on the X chromosome only. So if we look at this particular pedigree, we remember that if you're filled in, you have the recessive phenotype. We can look at this first individual. He's male, so we know he has to be XY and not colorblind, so that X has to have the normal gene on it. This individual, female, is XX, and because she's colorblind, we know she has to be homozygous recessive. Again, you can go through this entire pedigree and fill out known information. So any female that's colorblind has to be homozygous recessive. So we've got one here, we've got one here. For the males, we also know their phenotype. If they are colorblind, they have the color blindness on their X, and if they don't, they are normal. So the only thing we have to figure out are these females, and are they carriers or are they homozygous dominant? So let's look at the possible combinations in a quick Punnett square. Here we have a father with normal vision and colorblind mother. And so that's this cross here between grandma and grandpa. So we'll go ahead and make the crosses. Notice 50% of the kids are male and 50% are female. And of the males, all of them are going to be colorblind. And none of the girls are going to be colorblind. So this is what we mean with an X-linked trait. It shows up in the males and more often is just carried by the females. And we can see that's what happened. Here they had two sons, both of them are colorblind, and they had two daughters. And we've determined here that both of these daughters must be carriers. If we look at a different cross, here we have a normal father and a carrier mother. Again, half of the offspring are male and half are female. And half of the sons, 50% of the sons, are colorblind. None of the girls are colorblind, but both of them are carriers. So based on this Punnett square, we can eliminate this possibility. Both of these girls are carriers. And here we're going to cross a normal father with a carrier. And you're going to see that 50% of the sons are getting the disease. And you would predict, as you see here, both of the daughters are normal. 50% will likely be carriers. 50% will be normal. So what we see in sex-linked traits is that they're carried by the female part of the family, but they show up in the male part of the family. This is another example showing hemophilia, which is also an X-linked trait where women tend to be the carriers and males tend to actually get the disease. Hemophilia is when your blood doesn't have the normal ability to clot, and so if you get cut, you can bleed and bleed and bleed and not survive. So we'll finish sex-linked traits with a fun little video about whether men are going extinct or not.